Solar systems involve intricate components, each with its unique role. From the cables that transport power and connectors that bind them, to the connection diagram, today we journey through the technical details of Epever off-grid inverter wiring. Starting with cables, there are two main types, DC and AC. Each is designed differently, serving specific functions. For instance, on the DC side, avoid using non-flexible cables. In the world of cable materials, we have three main choices: silver, copper, and aluminum. Silver is a top conductor but is too expensive for solar use. Copper is the favorite for solar because of its great conductivity. Aluminum, while cheaper, isn't as efficient. This can mean more energy loss. Also, watch out for wires that look like copper but have aluminum inside, which are called copper-clad wires. They can't carry as much current, and over time, they might break or overheat, leading to risks. The environment in which cables are installed can greatly impact their efficiency. High temperatures demand heat-resistant cables, damp areas necessitate water-resistant ones, and areas with intense UV exposure require UV-resistant cables. So in each condition, the appropriate cable is needed. You might come across solid core cables and stranded cables. Now, stranded cables, having more strands, naturally have more surface area for the current to flow. This often means they conduct electricity better than their solid core counterparts. And because they're flexible, stranded cables are a top pick for solar power setups. Moving on to wire gauge, which is basically how thick the wire is, and its length, both are super important. A wire that's long and thin can resist the flow of electricity. If this resistance gets too high, it not only means more energy loss, but can even lead to fires. Besides cables, some elements are needed, from cable lugs to the tools used. It's vital to strip insulation with precision, so specialized stripping tools are recommended. Always avoid using inappropriate tools, which can compromise connections and lead to overheating. Keeping connections moisture-free is key to prevent corrosion. And consistent resistance is achieved by ensuring proper alignment and the right tightening torque. Remember, consistency in components and installation leads to optimal system performance. Solar system protection is a multi-layered approach, ranging from surge arrestors to circuit breakers and fuses safeguarding the equipment. Adhering to this multi-tiered strategy is essential for system safety, as each layer addresses specific surge energy levels. While surge arrestors and lightning systems handle high surge currents, selecting the appropriate fuse and wiring size are equally crucial. Typically, the current rating should be set according to the system's maximum current. When you want to move power efficiently, picking the right wire size is very important. Factors such as maximum current, allowable voltage drops, and specific equipment specs are fundamental. Always start with product manuals and wire sizing charts as reference points. If you're looking to calculate on your own, there are many things to think about. Calculate current. For both DC and AC power, you need to find out the maximum current. However, this isn't the sole determiner of wire size. Voltage drop also matters. Strive for a voltage drop below 3% for DC and 5% for AC. Use online tools. There are online calculators that can help you decide the right wire size. You will need the parameters which we discussed, like system current, input or output voltage, distance, voltage drop, ambient temperature, and some other parameters. Think about equipment. Be sure to consider the unique requirements of your inverter and battery. Pick the right covering. When selecting insulation, account for environmental factors, such as needing UV resistance, and always remember to adhere to local regulations. And a useful tip to bear in mind: thicker cables on the DC side usually perform better. For the AC side, the optimal choice might vary based on the number of inverters and their configuration. In this segment, we will determine the wire and fuse sizes for a system with IPT 1522, The method for determining fuse sizes depends on whether the load details are known. Accordingly, two methods are proposed. First method, when load details are known. There's a formula for the system current calculation here. Sum the power ratings of all devices running simultaneously and divide by the system voltage. The resulting figure should be multiplied by a safety factor, with 1.5 being typical for copper to account for slight overloads. Let's break down the process step by step. First up is the AC current calculation. If the total consumption of your loads is, for example, 1,350 W and the AC voltage is 230 V, our calculations reveal an AC current of 5.87 amperes. Simple math, just divide total load power by output voltage. Next, we tackle the AC fuse. For the AC fuse, based on our calculations, we recommend one that can handle 8.8 amperes. That's 1.5 times our earlier AC current of 5.87 amperes. Note that when calculating the AC fuse current, the safety factor for copper conductor can be chosen within the range of 1.3 to 1.5. Select a factor based on actual conditions. Moving on to DC side. The DC current calculation. For our loads, with a power again at 1,350 W and our system voltage at 24 V, the DC current works out to be 56.25 amperes. Again, straightforward, total load power divided by input voltage. For the DC fuse, based on our calculations, we recommend one that can handle 84.38 amperes. When determining the fuse current for a DC circuit, it's advisable to select a safety factor for the copper conductor between 1.5 and 2. This choice should be guided by the specific conditions of your application. So for DC fuse, the closest value higher than 84.38 is okay. Lastly, let's discuss wire sizing. According to the IPT manual for IPT 1522 on the DC side, a 5 AWG or 16 square millimeter wire size with an RNB14 6S ring terminal and a DC 2 poles 125 amperes fuse is recommended. And on the AC side, a 15 AWG wire or approximately 1.5 square millimeter with an AC 2 poles 10 amperes fuse is recommended. Note that you can also use an online wire size calculator instead of the product manual. But note that it may differ from the size given in the manual, because the manual offers the maximum size of the wire you'll need. When employing the first method, where load details are known, it's important to factor in the inrush current of certain appliances to accommodate this initial surge in current and prevent unnecessary fuse trips. Consider using slow blow fuses, which are specifically designed to handle such transient current spikes. Second method, when the load details are not clear. Again, there's a formula for the system current calculation. Take the maximum surge power of your inverter and divide it by the system voltage. Be sure to use the inverter's peak or surge power, not the continuous rating. Again, first up is the AC current calculation. Given a surge power of 3,000 W and an AC voltage of 230 V, our calculations reveal an AC surge current of 13.04 amps and for the DC current during the surge for our inverter, with a surge power again at 3,000 W and our system voltage at 24 V, the DC surge current works out to be 125 amps. According to this calculation, you can use a 14 amps fuse on the AC side and 125 amps fuse on the DC side. Determining wire size. For wire size calculation, using an online calculator in this method is recommended. So it's important to consider various factors, including the current carrying capacity, voltage drop, length of the wire run, and ambient temperature conditions. Online calculators take all these parameters into account, ensuring a safe and efficient electrical installation. DC input side. According to the online calculator, a 1 AWG wire or 50 square millimeter with a 3% voltage drop over a typical distance is recommended. AC output side. Again, according to the same calculator, a 14 AWG wire or approximately 2.5 square millimeter is suitable. This wire size can handle up to approximately 16 amperes with a 5% voltage drop over a typical distance, for example, 5 meters. Note that the wire sizes we've recommended are based on general copper wire resistance values. Refer to the manual or tools for specific calculations. And note that these examples serve primarily as a guide. Before finalizing your setup, it's crucial to consult a certified electrician. Always adhere to regional electrical standards and wire manufacturer guidelines to ensure the safety and efficiency of your off-grid system. Communication cables are less critical as they carry significantly lower amounts of current and voltages. Off-grid inverters have two primary designs for DC inputs and AC socket placement. The separate configuration places them on opposite ends, evident in models like IP1542+. On the other hand, the combined configuration has both on the same side, as seen for example in the IPT3012 model. Stay tuned for our next videos.